Hey, welcome everybody. We have a full room, really cool. Today I would like to talk about increasing your productivity with IntelliJ. My name is Bauke Nijhuis, I'm from the Netherlands, and I work for a company called SyncICT. So I would like to start with the why. Why am I here talking about this subject? A little time ago, I started thinking about craftsmanship, and one of the things about craftsmanship is knowing your tools inside out. So I decided to apply this rule to our craft, software engineering. I decided to learn my main tool, my editor, IntelliJ, inside out. So I spend a lot of evenings reading articles, watching YouTube videos, and just plainly clicking around in the UI to learn all the things there was to learn about IntelliJ. So I learned a lot in this journey, and I decided to create a presentation, this presentation. Unfortunately, I only have 30 minutes because I could talk the entire day about the subject, so I'm only going to show you the tip of the iceberg. Then the how. There are no fancy slides. The entire presentation will be IntelliJ, so this is basically a 30-minute live coding session. Currently, IntelliJ is in a presentation mode, so I have a really nice big font, and there are no distractions around my edit window. During the session, I will use one plugin called Presentation Assistant. Let me show you what it does. I'm going to copy the word presentation by using my touchpad. And if I press copy over here, there will be a pop-up in the top right corner over here. It will tell you I performed a copy. The action that I have performed is a copy. And it will show you two shortcut keys, the one for Windows and the one for Mac. So talking about shortcuts, whenever you ask people, how can I become more effective with a tool, they quickly start talking about using keyboard shortcuts. And I agree with those people. In most cases, a keyboard shortcut is the fastest way to perform an action. This is also true for IntelliJ. Having said that, I also think there's a place and time for the mouse. I really like the mouse for scrolling. The scroll wheel is awesome. But I also like the mouse to navigate complex dialogues. So use the right tool at the right time. And the last thing I try to prevent is switches. So when my hands are on a keyboard, I try to prevent to switch to the mouse and vice versa. Every switch you save, you don't do, saves you time. Last thing, I would advise you during the session to focus on the capabilities of IntelliJ and on the actions that I'm performing. Please do not focus on the keyboard shortcuts. Once you know the name of an action, it's pretty simple to look up the shortcut. The other way around is much harder. So the first thing I would like to talk about is navigation. We navigate a lot in our IDE, and I think there are two types of navigation. The first one is navigation from one source file to another source file to another to another. So we navigate a lot through our source files. And the second thing is navigating within the IDE itself. So currently you see the edit window, but normally there are those two windows around the edit window, and we also navigate a lot from the edit window to the two windows. IntelliJ has ways to really optimize those navigations, and I'm going to show them to you. So if we can improve or speed up our navigation, we will save a lot of time and therefore become more productive. The first thing I want to show you is Search Everywhere. And the shortcut is Shift-Shift, both on Windows and on Mac. And it looks like this. So this is the Search Everywhere pop-up. Search Everywhere does almost what it says. It searches almost everywhere in the project. I'll come back to that later. For now, I would like to focus on the big gray bar on top. So currently it's on all, but there are all kinds of categories. So if it's on all, you can search through all the categories that are there. Let's focus on the categories. So first, there is classes. Of course, you use this to search for classes. In this project, there is one class called Hello World. So you just type part of the name, and the class will pop up. If I would press Enter, it would navigate to this class. This classes thing is pretty smart, because you can also only type the capitals, and it will still find the proper class. This is not really important for Hello World, but if you have like a really long class name with six capitals in there, this will really speed things up. And lastly, it doesn't only search through the classes in your project, it also searches to the default Java classes. So let's say I need a file output stream, just typing the capitals will bring me to the file output stream. Then there is files. Of course, there are more files than classes in your project. I've just told you there are no fancy slides. I use text files, and if I type text properly, you see all the text files on the screen. So this is how you search other files within your project. Then there are symbols. Symbols are almost all things in Java that you can name our symbols. So think name of a class, name of a variable, name of a method. So let's see if there is a main method in my class. As it turns out, there is a main method in my class. Then my favorite category, actions. So in the past, whenever I wanted to perform an action in IntelliJ, I would grab the mouse, click through a few menus, and I would perform the action. But like I've said before, in most cases, it's faster to use the keyboard. So nowadays, I use this. So let's say I want to reformat my code. So I type a part of reformat code, and there it is. If I would press Enter, it would reformat my code. It also gives you a shortcut. This is a Windows shortcut because I'm giving this presentation on a Windows machine. If you would be on Mac, of course, you would get the Mac shortcut. So it also helps you learning new keyboard shortcuts. Another one is I use a lot is Open Recent Project. And you see you can also over here, you can use the capital trick. So you just type the capitals and it will bring you to the proper action. And even in this case, you don't even need capitals because small letters also work. This isn't the case for classes. If you search for a class, you really have to use the capitals. Otherwise, the search engine will find something else. And lastly, there's the JIT category, and you can search for all things JIT related. So let's see if there is a master branch. There is a master branch. And let's see if there are commit messages. So I'm searching for initial commit, and there it is. If I would press Enter, it would open up the tool window in the bottom part of my screen and select a proper commit, and you can do whatever you want to do with your commit. Then the last thing I want to show you is a kind of a party trick. This Search Everywhere can also do calculations. So the next time when you want to calculate something, you don't have to leave your IDE anymore, you just do it over here. Also something I learned during my journey of learning more about IntelliJ. So I've just told you it's called Search Everywhere, but actually it searches almost everywhere in your project because it doesn't do a full text search. If you want to look up a to-do or a string you created somewhere, you still have to use find in files. For people who are not familiar with find in files, and Windows is Ctrl-Shift-F, the Mac shortcuts over there. So this one, the hello, I wouldn't find if I would use Search Everywhere. So then the last thing, there is a reason I started with Search Everywhere. When I'm coding, I try to do everything with my keyboard. So I try to not use the mouse. But sometimes I have to perform an action of which I don't know the direct keyboard shortcut. So in that case, I just tap, I start typing whatever I want to do. And then in 99% of the cases, the action that I want to perform is there. So I hardly have to use the mouse anymore. OK, let's go to the switcher. On Windows, if you want to switch application, you use Alt-Tab. On Mac, if you want to switch applications, you use Command-Tab. In IntelliJ, if you want to switch open files, you use Control-Tab. So let me show you a quick Control-Tab. So currently, I'm on the navigation slide. I'm going to do a quick Control-Tab, and then it's going to go to the previous file, the introduction slide. See? And I'm going to quickly Control-Tab again, and I go back to navigation. I'm saying quickly on purpose, because if I hold the control, I get this menu. It's called the switcher. And on the right, you see all the open files. And on the left, you see all the tool windows. There are several ways to navigate through this pop-up menu. If I just press Tab, it will go to the next item in the list. And if I use Shift-Tab, I go back. When I release the tab, it will open the currently selected item. So currently, it's on project. So now I'm releasing the tab, and it will open up the project tool window on the left. There are several ways of closing this tool window again, or hiding it. And the first one I want to show you is called Hide Active Tool Window. So I press Shift Escape, and I'm back in my editor. Back to the switcher. Another way to navigate is with the arrow keys. So you can just navigate wherever you need to be. And notice that there are numbers, and those are underlined, and there are some letters over here as well. You can also use those. So now I'm going to press the 1. I'm still holding the control, otherwise the switcher would already switch. And if I press 1, it also brings me to the project tool window. Another way to close a tool window is close file. So this shortcut can be used to close file, but also used to close all tool windows. If you don't like holding control for some reason, there's also something similar called recent files. Again, on the right, you see all the files, only now there are more files, not only the open files, but also the recently touched files. And again, on the left, you see all the tool windows. And look at that, there is a direct keyboard shortcut over here. So apparently, I can also open up the project tool window with Alt-1. Let's try that. Alt-1, it works. If you want to close it again, another Alt-1, and it closes again. This works for all the tool windows. So I've shown you several ways of navigating pretty quickly through the source code, but also pretty quickly through the IDE itself. If you will use those methods, you will just save a lot of time and therefore become more productive. The last thing I want to show you is last edit location. And this is one of my favorites, and it's really helpful for people with faulty memory like myself. So let me show you how this works. So I'm happily editing this slide, and now I need a piece of information that's currently not on the screen, and I also don't know where the piece of information is. So I start searching, and this is how it typically goes. So I go over here. So maybe it's in an introduction slide. No, not over there. So maybe it's in the title slide. No, damn. Maybe the piece of information is over here. No, it's not over here as well. So maybe it's, there's the piece of information I'm looking for. So now I made so many hops in my mind that I don't remember what I was doing, or sometimes I don't remember where I was doing it. Luckily, IntelliJ got you covered. It has something called last edit location, and if you press the proper keys, it brings you back to the last edit location. Really helpful for people like me. So let me clean this up a little. So that's everything I wanted to tell you about navigation. Let's go to the next theme called refactoring. So we programmers love to code, right? We write our tests, then we write our code, and then if all the tests are green, we want to improve our code. We want to refactor, we want to make it better. And IntelliJ can really help you out with that. There are a lot of refactorings IntelliJ can do for you, and I'm pretty sure IntelliJ can also do them faster than you can. So let's start with refactor this. But before I can show you refactor this, we need some code. We need a playground so I can show off the capabilities of IntelliJ. Like I said before, there is a Hello World class in the project, and it's pretty simple. What it does, it prints Hello World, but in a little bit complex way. And I needed this complexity to be able to show off the capabilities of IntelliJ. So it's not the most simple way, but it's the one that will work for this presentation. So there is a main method, which will print a line. And whatever it will print is created by the format message method. The format message method has two parameters, first and second. And it will use a string format to format the string. So we take the first argument, then there is a space, second argument, and then an exclamation mark. So let's see if it really prints out hello space world exclamation mark. I'm on purpose using a slow way to run the program, or at least not the most efficient way to run the program. So in a later part of the presentation, I will show you a more efficient way. But as it turns out, the program works. It printed hello world over here. Really happy with that. Okay, the reason that I'm showing you this code is because I want to show off the refactor this menu. And the first thing I want to tell you about refactor this is highly context sensitive. So that it really matters where you call it. So currently, I put my cursor on the main method, and I press the shortcuts, and there is the refactor this menu. And it has a long list of refactorings it can do for you. Unfortunately, I cannot explain all the refactorings because we only have 30 minutes, but I will show one in a minute, and I want to tell a little bit about the rename. I think rename is my most used one and also my most favorite. I remember being in university about 20 years ago, and then we created Java programs in Notepad. And whenever we wanted to rename something, if we were lucky, it took 15 minutes to get everything compiling again. And if we were unlucky, it took hours to get everything compiling again. So nowadays, your IDE just solves that for you in under a second. So the thing I want to show you is introduce variable. It's currently not in the list because you cannot introduce a variable when your cursor is at the main method. But you can introduce a variable if your cursor is over here. So the thing I want to do, I want to introduce a variable. So the part that's currently selected should become a variable. So of course I can do this by hand. So I can select it, I can cut it, I can create a new line, enter the name of the variable, enter the value, and use the name of the variable at this spot. But just explaining this already took me like 10 seconds. And if you have to do it, it probably takes you 20 seconds. And IntelliJ can do it really fast. And I'm going to show you two ways. The first one is by using the refactor this menu. So it's over here. It says introduce variable. If I press enter, it will introduce a variable. But notice on the right over here, there is also a direct keyboard shortcut. So that's the one I'm going to use the second time. For now, I'm just going to press enter. And IntelliJ performs the refactoring. It comes up with a name for the variable. And in most cases, this name is pretty fine. And there are some options that I won't use. So I just press enter. And there it is. IntelliJ introduced a variable for me within 10 seconds while I was still explaining it. So let me show you an even faster way using the direct keyboard shortcut. So now I just press two keys. And there it is. Under a second, IntelliJ introduced a variable, assigned a value to it, and it used the variable. So I've shown you refactor this, the menu. I've shown you introduce variable. There's an X on the slide on purpose because you can introduce all kinds of things. You can introduce parameters. You can introduce constants. You can extract methods, inline variables. There's so many things to do in the refactor this menu. So I would really advise you to spend some time to get familiar with all the capabilities of this tool. The last thing I want to show you regarding refactoring is move line or move element. So we need some code for that. And I'm going to move line 8, so the one containing the string format. This is called move line. So you can just move a line throughout your application. And this is really helpful. Because in the past, I would select the entire line. I would cut it. I would go to the new location. I would paste it. Then I would probably, sometimes I have to add an enter. I would have to add an enter. Sometimes I don't. And probably I have a white empty line somewhere and I have to clean it up. This is so much more convenient. You directly see what the end result is. This was the dumb way. There's also a smart way called move statement. The previous one was move line. And now you cannot see it, but I'm tapping the arrow key to go down. But it doesn't go out of the method. And if I go up, I cannot go out of the method. Use the one that's most appropriate for you while working. This also works for multiple lines. So now I use the dumb way, move line, and now I'm mixing methods, so I'm breaking everything up. So this one is really flexible. You can do whatever you want, but it also has its perils. If I use the smart way, so move statement, you will see it will swap the order of the methods. You see, it will prevent me from making mistakes. So it will try to help me. So we've moved stuff up and down through the file. Now I want to move stuff from left to right. And to be able to move stuff from left to right, we need a list. And luckily, there's a list over here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to swap the order of the arguments. So the first argument becomes the second argument and vice versa. In the past, I would select it, I would cut it, I would go to the end of the argument list, I would add a comma, I would paste it, I would go back to the previous position, remove the first comma, and there would be spaces all over the place. Nowadays, I do this, move element. You see, I swapped the elements. I can easily swap them back again. And this works on any list in IntelliJ. So if you have a list with 10 items, you can easily make the third item the 8th item. So powerful stuff. That's everything I wanted to tell you about refactoring. I see I have 12 minutes left. Then we go to the bonus slide. Okay, the first thing I want to show you is run anything. So before I've shown you a way to run something, let me show it again. So I go to the code, I grab my mouse, I go to this little triangle, and I click twice, and it runs the program. And it's pretty fast. But I think there is a better way. And the better way is called run anything. So let's go back to the slide. So I'm over here, and now I want to run my program. So run anything is control, control on Windows and on Mac, and it looks like this. And now you can just start typing. So I type hello world. I go down here, I press enter, and now it will run my program. I think this is a far superior way to the previous one because I didn't have to switch from this file to the other file. So I don't have to remember where I was working. And also, I didn't have to grab the mouse. I only used the keyboard. So I did it pretty fast. Then there is extend and shrink selection. So in the past, when I wanted to select something, I mostly used the mouse. So I went with the mouse to the start position, dragged it to the end position, and then I'd select something. Nowadays, I also do selections with keyboards, and IntelliJ has something called extend and shrink selection. Let me show it to you. So let me show it off. The shortcut on Windows is Control W, and the more times I press it, the bigger my selection comes. And if I add Shift, it becomes smaller again. So this is the way to do it with your keyboard. And I think in there are a lot of cases in which this is faster than using the mouse. So let's say I want to select the first argument. I just tap twice on my keyboard and I selected the first argument. If I want to do this with the mouse, I first have to bring the cursor over here. Hopefully I don't make a mistake. Here, I get pop-ups. Hopefully I don't make a mistake. And then I have to bring it to the end. And again, I have to position it really precise. So I think using the keyboard is a really quick way to do selections. Then the last thing I would like to talk about is column selection mode. And column selection mode is if you want to do something on multiple lines at the same time. So there are several ways to do this, and the easiest way to do this is with the mouse. So now I'm pressing Alt, and then I'm dragging down. And now you see I have three cursors. So let's say I want to replace the bullets with minuses. Bam. And I think it's even more powerful if you do it at the end of the end of the line, because at the end of the line is, in most cases, they're in a different position. Let's say I want to add something at the end of every line. I can just add it, and it will be, I can just type, and it will be added to any line. So that's I will clean it up later. Let's go to the last slide, which is called wrap-up. So the most important thing that I can tell you is let the IDE work for you. I've shown you ways to quickly navigate throughout the IDE. I also shown you how the IDE can help you refactor things. Like I've said before, the IDE can do a lot of refactorings, and very probably it can do it faster than you can. So I would advise you to spend some time to learn about the capabilities of IntelliJ. And once you know more capabilities, then the next thing we should talk about is performing those actions as fast as possible. And like I said before, in most cases, a keyboard shortcut, a direct keyboard shortcut, is the fastest way to perform an action in IntelliJ. And of course, when you're just starting out, or like me, if you have been using IntelliJ for 5 years, you do not know all keyboard shortcuts, and that's fine. And for me, there's a spectrum. Over here, you can use the mouse, and over here, you can use the direct keyboard shortcut. But luckily, there's also something in between. And I call it a pop-up menu, and this is not an official term. But what I mean by it is something like search everywhere. So you don't have to use the mouse. You don't know the direct keyboard shortcut, but there is it pops up, and you just start typing, and then you can do whatever you want to do. Also, a great example of pop-up menu is refactor this, and you press the key, and then there's a list of things you can select a proper action from. And in most cases, this pop-up menu will also show you the direct keyboard shortcut. So the next time you can use the direct and the fastest way to call this action. The last thing I want to tell you is what I do when I'm coding. Sometimes during the day, I just put my mouse away for 5 or 10 minutes, and then I challenge myself to only use the keyboard. So I just keep coding, and then sometimes I have to perform an action. I have to do something I don't know how to do without the mouse. So the first thing I do is press Shift-Shift or start typing whatever I want to do. And in 99% of the cases, this is more than enough. You really don't need a mouse. So that brings me to the end of this presentation. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening to me. I hope you've learned something new. I have a question for you. Who knew you could do calculations in IntelliJ? Nobody. Okay, that's what I expected. So everybody learned something new. That's really nice. There's some time left for questions. Thank you. So are there any questions? Yeah, I'm seeing it. Oh, then there's a mic. Excellent.
Thanks for the talk. So I use IntelliJ with on Linux.
Yeah.
And since I've been using Vim a lot, I combine IntelliJ with Vim Editor.
Sorry, I can hear you really badly. It's coming only out of that.
So I use IntelliJ with Vim. And so I switch to, when I want to edit a file within IntelliJ, I use Vim Editor, which gives me all the facilities of, you know, running Vim scripts or Vim mode abilities.
Yeah.
And so when I'm not editing, when I'm in the tool mode, then I switch to using, for instance, like if I want to say, find the definition or the implementation of code, I go and use a Control-Alt-P. So would you recommend using Vim Editor mode with IntelliJ or not?
So which mode again, sorry?
Vim.
Vim mode?
Yeah.
So that this, what is Vim? I don't exactly know what Vim mode is, but I think it gives you certain shortcuts?
Yes, via Vim, the Linux Vim Editor.
And your question exactly was?
Would you recommend using Vim mode with IntelliJ where you can switch between using Vim and IntelliJ shortcuts?
Yeah, whatever you like. Do whatever works best for you. I don't use Vim, so for me it would be a bad, how do you say that? I wouldn't use it. For me, it would slow me down. But if you're used to Vim shortcuts, yeah, of course, use it.
Thank you.
Are there any other? Yeah, I see one over there.
Do you have any recommendations for like katas or any resources that you were using when you were trying to get better at using shortcuts, that sort of stuff? I've been trying to find myself recommending things to people, and I've always
Yeah, let me repeat the questions for the people at home. The question is, are there any good resources to learn more about this stuff? As it turns out, IntelliJ has one as a tutorial or something. There's a lot of cool stuff in there. But like I said in the presentation, I watch YouTube videos. There are a lot of people out there creating YouTube videos. Also the people from JetBrains themselves, they create great YouTube videos. I also follow them on Twitter, so now and then I get really cool tips. And like I said before, I just clicked around. Just clicking around to see what it can do. It helps a lot. So sorry, that's the best answer I have for you. Yeah.
Continue on that question. There's a plugin that actually counts how many times you use a certain option.
Yeah. Yeah, so somebody from the audience says there's a plugin, and I think he means Key Promoter X. Yeah, so I used to use the plugin as well. I prepared this presentation with this plugin as well, but then I had two pop-ups. So I had the Key Promoter X and the Presentation Assistant, so I decided to kill one of the two. But I do also use Key Promoter X, so I can advise you to use it as well. It will tell you the keyboard shortcut, and it will also tell you how many times you didn't use the keyboard shortcut. So. It can make a list of the things you can benefit most from. Yeah.
I'm just interested with the run anywhere. Obviously you've got like run configurations. And you've got Maven and Drupal 12.
Yeah.
I mean, how does it work in relation to those, and does it enable you to save run configurations and
like that? I can show you. Now it's in presentation mode, but let me bring it out of presentation mode. So everything that's up here, that's what you mean by run configurations, right? Yeah, you can run them as run anything. Did that answer your question?
If you're building like with, say, Drupal or Maven, is it possible to use run anywhere?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, let me repeat the question because I've got to repeat the question. The question was, can you also run Maven or Gradle commands? And actually, I prepared to show you one, but I forgot. So let me show you how you can do a Maven compile. So run anything, control, you just type your Maven command, you press compile, and there it goes. I'm not sure, I do have internet, so. You see? Works awesomely. So that's why it's called run anything, and not only run projects or something. It just, you can type and it will run anything it's able to run. Yep.
I came from Eclipse background, so Eclipse there is a plugin development stuff there. Do they have IntelliJ also have the similar things?
The question is if IntelliJ has plugin support?
Yeah, plugin support.
Yeah. There's a lot of plugins. Let me show you really quickly. I press Shift, my default fallback key. I type plugin, and I think the third one is the one we want. And then you go to this marketplace over here, and then you can type something. Somebody just talked about Key Promoter X. You see? I have it installed, but currently I don't use it. But yeah, there is a plugin market, and it's pretty simple. You just click it, and I even believe, but I'm not sure, that nowadays you don't even have to restart IntelliJ anymore if you want to install something, but I'm not sure about that one. Okay, I have 1 minute left. So who wants the last question? Nobody. Are there any questions from online? No? Okay, thank you for being here.
Bye-bye.